गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9. एज यू नो दैट इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड हाउ द स्मॉल फार्मर्स अरेंज देयर मनी फॉर प्रोडक्शन पर्पजेस. दे बॉरोड मनी फ्रॉम मनी लेंडर्स, ट्रेडर्स, बिग फार्मर्स. सो टूडे I will discuss in what way the big farmers and medium farmers arrange their money for production purposes. So now let's start the portion. So now start that point. So now the point is sale of surplus farm products. Let us suppose that the farmers have produced wheat on their lands using the three factors of production. The wheat is harvested and production is complete. What do the farmers do with the wheat? They retain a part of wheat for the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat. Small farmers like Savita and Gobind Shans have little surplus wheat because their total production is small, and from this a substantial share is kept for their own family needs. So it is the medium and large farmers who supply wheat to the market. In the picture 1.1 you can see. So to give Tejpal Singh, the large farmer, has a surplus of 350 quintals of wheat from all his land. He sells the surplus wheat at the Raiganj market and has good earnings. What does Tejpal Singh do with his earnings? Last year, Tejpal Singh had put most of the money in his bank account. Later, he used the savings for lending to farmers like Savita who were in need of a loan. He also used the savings to arrange for the working capital for farming in the next session. This year, Tejpal Singh plans to use his earnings to buy another tractor. Another tractor would increase his fixed capital. So from this point, it is clear that for production purposes, the factors needed. So the farmers produced wheat on their land using the three factors. And they produced goods. After producing goods, they kept a portion for their consumption purposes, kept a portion of the food crops for consumption purposes, and rest of the portion. Rest of the portion means the extra food crops they sold in the market. So by selling the surplus food crops in the market, they earn money. Now the story of Tejpal Singh we had learned in the last classes. Tejpal Singh, a large farmer, and he has surplus of 350 quintals of wheat from his land, and he sells surplus wheat in the market. So the name of this market is Raiganj market, and he earned a good income. So with the help of this income, he saved this extra income in his bank account, and he thought that he lent his money to the small farmers. As for example, we have seen that Savita lent money from him for production purposes, and sometimes he thought that his saving he will invest for capital formation. He purchased a tractor. He decided he will purchase a tractor for production purposes. So in such a way he created the asset. So now we have like Tejpal Singh, other large medium farmers sell the surplus farm product. A part of earnings is saved and kept for buying capital for the next session. So in such a way the large or medium farmers sold their surplus food crops in the market, and in such a way they earned the extra income and saved their income in bank, and also purchased the capital for production purposes. In such a way they managed their saving. They are able to arrange for the capital for farming from their own saving. Some farmers might also use the saving to buy cattle, truck, or to set up shops. See, these constitute the capital for non-farm activities. So now next point is non-farm activities in Palanpur. We have learnt about farming as the main production activities in Palanpur. We shall now take a look at some of the non-farm production activities. Only 25% of the people working in Palampur are engaged in activities other than agriculture. So, in Palampur, most of the people we know that engaged in agricultural activities has a 75% dependent on land, but 25% people engaged other activities. So, this type of activities known as the non-farm activities in Palampur. So, number one, dairy. The other common activity, dairy is a common activity in many families of Palampur. People feed their buffaloes on various kinds of grass and the jowar and bajra that grows during the rainy season. The milk is sold in Raiganj, the nearby large village. Two traders from Sahapur town have set up collection cum chilling center at Raiganj, from where the milk is transported to far away towns and cities. Now the next point is number 2. An example of small scale manufacturing in Palampur. At present, less than 50 people are engaged in manufacturing in Palampur. Unlike the manufacturing that takes place in the big factories in the towns and cities, manufacturing in Palampur involves very simple production methods and are done small scale. They are carried out mostly at home or in the fields with the help of family labor. Rarely are laborers hired. Now the next point is number 3. The shopkeepers of Palampur. People involved in trade are not many in Palampur. The traders of Palampur are shopkeepers who buy various goods from wholesale market in the cities and sell them in the village. You will see small general stores in the village selling wide range of items like rice, wheat, sugar, tea, oil, biscuit, soap, toothpaste, batteries, candles, notebooks, paint, pencil, even some clothes. A few of the families whose houses are close to the bus stand have used a part of the space to open small shops. They sell eatables. So now the next point is transport, a first developing sector. There are a variety of vehicles on the road connecting Palampur to Raiganj. Rikshawala, Tangawala, Jeep, tractor, truck drivers and people driving the traditional bullock cart and buggy are people in the transport services. They ferry people and goods from one place to another and in return get paid for it. The number of people involved in transport has grown over the last several years. So from this we have seen that the 25% people engaged in non-farm activities, and these non-farm activities are dairy, number 2 small-scale manufacturing, number 3 point is the shopkeepers of Palampur, and transport system. So these are the non-farm activities, and 25% people only engaged in this type of activities. So at present we have seen that in non-farm sector in villages is not very large. Out of every 100 workers in the rural areas in India, only 25 are engaged in non-farm activities. So in the future, one would like to see more non-farm production activities in the village. Unlike farming, non-farm activities require little land. People with some amount of capital can set up non-farm activities. From this it is clear that production activities and farming activities as well as the non-farm activities both are played an important role in the villages. So in such a way, the Palampur, we can say that well developed, and the different types of activities performed by the different types of people. So in such a way, today I have completed this chapter, and I will send the question answer, CRT question answers in PDF form. So your duty is to write in your copy and also learn. After reopening the school, I will check your copy. So today I have completed the first chapter. Next day I will start the second chapter. Thank you.